Let's start with the group box, the first one for query term. One thing I'm going to show you only once is how to set a tooltip for a widget. So this can be done by selecting the widget and then in the property editor list on the right, look for the property that is called tooltip. And I'm entering the tooltip text, enter name to search for here as the tooltip. So every time the user hovers over this group box area for a longer time, this tooltip will appear to tell him what he can do there. And we can actually try that out by using the form menu and then the entry preview. And in the preview, we can actually try out our GUI. And if I hover over this group box in the window that is now open, you can see the tooltip appearing there, showing the text that I just entered. So going back to our form, and now you see that the first group box actually just has a single widget, namely something to that allows the user to enter some text, the search term. So this is a queue line edit widget that you find under input widgets in the list in Qt Designer on the left. And I'm going to drag this line edit widget over to the group box and dropping it in the right in the middle. And now we have added this line edit widget to the group box. Next thing is I'm going to change the layout of this group box to use also a vertical layout so that this line edit widget will actually expand it, will be expanded horizontally to fill the entire area. So I'm doing a right click in the empty area of the group box and then pick layout, layout vertically. And you see now the line edit fills the entire screen, the entire window. As explained in the text, it is important that we name the widgets that we need to refer to from our code to give them names that are easy to remember and that needs to be exactly the names I'm going to use here because the code shown later in this section of the lesson will refer to these names. So I select the line input widget and then do a right click and pick the change object name option. And then I'm going to name the widget query term line edit or query term LE, and the LE stands for line edit so that I know this is a line edit widget when I see the variable name. So that means that when this GUI is saved and then compiled into Python code, the variable that stores this line edit widget will be called query term LE. And if you look at the hierarchy at the top right in Qt Designer, you can actually now see the QLineEdit widget added as a child of the group box, and it's being named QueryTermLE. In the lesson text there, you find an image that shows you how the important widgets need to be named. So let me quickly pull that up. So this one right here. All the orange terms, the orange labels, specify the names that you need to give to the different widgets we are going to create in the following in order for the code later shown in the lesson to work. But I'm not going to do that for all of these because then the video would get much too long. It's just something that you will have to do if you want to use, if you are following along this video and want to then run the code with the GUI that you have created yourself. Okay, at this point we are done with the first group box for entering the query term and we can move on to the second one.